This week on The Bottom Line, a couple of Navy ships almost hit each other. The residents of Miami Beach have had it with charter boats. And a very important topic, if you're not happy on yachts, get the F off. And this is The Bottom Line. Hey everybody, I'm Doug, and Paige is not here. I'm going to explain real fast what's going on. First of all, we all took some time off. I went down to the Keys in my boat. I had a lovely experience here. Watch this. I'm just cruising through in this beautiful waters. It was kind of rough. And Georgia is up in Washington. She went to the Smithsonian Institute. Georgia has to report that the whole waterfront in Washington is making this big change for yachts. I mean, not for yachts, but it could be a place for you guys to bring your boats on your way north or south. I know it's a haul to get up the river, you know, the Potomac, but it might be worth it. I mean, hey, look, Star Trek fan. She even went here. That's where the original Star Trek Enterprise is. It's in the Smithsonian Institute. Pretty cool. Okay, let's jump right in it. And by the way, I'm not filming in the worldwide studio or on the boat. I'm filming in my workshop because, you know, we all need hobbies, and I just thought I'd do this. You know, obviously you can see what my hobby is. It's sniffing glue. I mean, this is really good stuff. Okay, let's jump right in it. First of all, our sponsors, Marine Data Solutions. Marine Data Solutions is technically the most, I think, advanced marine data company in Fort Lauderdale. They're not just pumping out the data, because they do. They have big factories. But they're also trying to stay ahead of it. I mean, they're trying to get ahead of things to kind of keep everything seamless on your boats. So you really should check them out. And don't forget, if you have 99 problems on board.
One of them.
And Salty Rags Crew Apparel is operating at 120%. Dave needs help too. If you want a job, a land-based job, maybe between boats, call Dave. Only between the hours of midnight and 3 a.m. because he's the rest of the time he's working. And you get to drive around in this cool car. It's all black. It's, you know, look at it. It's cool. You know, embroidery, linens, towels, everything. They do everything. And then we're going to jump into Hargrave Custom Yachts. Now, if your boss is building a boat, you get to help him build it. I got some news for you. They got a brand new boat coming in this month. We're going to try and get on it. It's going to be pretty cool. Also, I got some other news. This is top secret stuff, so don't even. So somebody, I'm not saying who, I'm not saying which factory, company, Hargrave, they built a boat. They were so happy with it before they even launched it. They already said, let's build another one. I mean, this is how hot Hargrave is right now, so it's pretty cool. And last but not least is Interior Technology Services. What do? They clean the walls, they clean the carpets, they keep the cushions, everything. They do everything. If you need a fire retardant certificate due to your class of vessel, they'll do it for you. How do you tell? Simple. Try and start your carpet on fire. If it burns, you don't need the certificate because that means you don't have a fire retardant carpet. If it doesn't burn, you better call those guys. Also, they'll clean the crew if you line them up next to the wall. All right, let's jump into yacht industry news. Okay, don't forget, we support $150 per day for day workers. Pay the munchkins. Give me a break. Feed them. Don't put them in Ubers and the limos that they're asking for, you know, whatever. But listen, we need these guys in the industry because that's where everybody starts out. Technically, I guess. I didn't. But most crews show up in Lauderdale and they day work. Lauderdale is probably the day working capital of the world. It goes on pretty much year round. So pay them $150 minimum. Okay. First, take a look at this video.
2 Worship 49, we're...
Worship 49, we're coming to port to avoid you. Worship 92, we are coming to port to avoid
two Navy ships in San Diego almost hit each other. How could this be possible? Two battle-ready U.S. Navy ships almost collided in the channel right next to the Navy base. One is what they call an LSD. I know what you guys are thinking. Drugs are not involved. It is a landing dock ship. And the other one was a pretty badass destroyer. That goes very fast and very maneuverable. Matter of fact, it probably could handle, you know, turning around just like a yacht. All right, why am I telling you guys this? Because you guys need to look out the window. All right, it's that simple. Modern technology as all have, oh, if it's not on AIS, it's not there. Baloney, okay? Everybody's just looking at screens now. If it's not your phone, it's your navigation. If these guys looked out the window, they would have seen this huge other ship coming their way. We all know what happened to Utopia 4. If they looked out the window, they probably wouldn't have sank that tanker. I mean, how? I'm going to tell you this right now. If you look out the window when you're on the bridge underway, the odds of hitting a boat go down like 80%. I guarantee it. I don't know what the math is, but I guarantee it's at least 80% if you're actually looking out the window. All right. Anyway, next. So, Western Rivers. Everybody who has a license, it's like you got offshore, you got coastal, you got inland, you got Western Rivers. I don't have a Western River license, but I've never driven a boat there. But apparently, there's no water to drive one there anyway. The drought has drained all the water out of the Mississippi and Tennessee rivers. And look at this boat. This is the riverboat Diamond Lady. It sank years ago, all right? And so much water has drained out of the rivers. I think this was the Tennessee River, that now it's not sunk anymore. Now it's just sitting on the beach. It's craziness. Why am I telling you this? Because if you're cruising, you know, Western Rivers, make sure you got enough water underneath. Now, we all know the problem with illegal immigration. Well, I don't know. This is not a political show. But I just spent 3 days in the Keys, and while I was there, I don't even know what kind of boats you call them, rafts, anything that they can make out of paper mache or whatever, landed in the Keys. I mean, law enforcement was running all over the place in their big go-fast rubber boats. It was pretty cool. I mean, you know, the badass guys with the belts and everything. I was at Postcard Inn. Take a look at this video. We were underway, and hours earlier, this boat just hit the reef, and everybody left, all right? And that's a pretty big boat. It's just sitting there. I talked to the dockmaster there, and he's like, yeah, another one came in. There was 111 people on board. I'm like, and he's like, yeah, whatever. I mean, we are getting invaded by these guys. And you know what? Why am I telling you this? Because if you're in Hawks Channel at night, none of these boats have running lights. They don't have engines. You're not going to hear them. You're not going to see them. Got to look out the window. I mean, I would even in Hawks Channel post a lookout up on the flybridge if you're in the wheelhouse, because you could just cut right through one of these wooden boats and you won't even know it. That boat had 111 people on board. So you really have to be very careful down in the Keys right now, especially at night. Oh, and by the way, they say there's an 11 million illegal immigrants in the United States. Just to put that in perspective, I looked it up. That is the combined population of Massachusetts and Connecticut. That's a lot of people. Connecticut and Massachusetts population equals all the illegal immigrants. So just something to think about. Okay, next. We're going to move down to Miami Beach. Miami Beach has had enough. The bareboat charter operation down in Miami is just a total shit show. I'm not kidding. I mean, it's not just the boats. It's not just the captains. It's not just the owners. It is the people that are chartering the boats. It's the people who, after they get off the boat, they are destroying South Beach with their drunkenness, their twerking, their half nakedness, which some people, you know, not me, but some people, you know, take offense to. Parking their cars anywhere, blocking people in. So it's gotten so bad that Suntex, who owns Miami Beach Marina, is going to start here. They were on the news. Here, watch this.
The operators of the marina sent us a statement saying, Suntex is aware that there have been customer behavioral issues that have impacted our neighbors in adjacent condos. Suntex has undertaken steps to address those issues, such as the non-renewal of certain 10-day charters and the eviction of customers where warranted due to behavioral issues. Suntex is currently working with and will continue to work with both the City of Miami Beach and our neighbors to improve the situation.
Suntex is saying that they're going to start kicking out. It's kind of hard to read. I don't know what they're trying to say, but it looks like charter boats, if you're there for more than 10 days, y'all out. All right. They don't even want you guys there. It goes even further. Apparently that there is now a motion in Miami Beach to ban bareboat charters. All right. They've had enough. They've been trying to get rid of bareboat charters for years. And I was just down there on my boat, and it's a freaking mess. None of these boats are compliant. None of these boats are seaworthy. They're overloaded. Half the captains don't know what the hell they're doing. There are a bunch of captains that do, but you can't tell because everybody talks up such a big game. It's like you were a valet 1 week, then you bought a sea ray. Now you're a captain. Now you're a charter agent. Now you're a yacht owner. And it's like, it's a smoke show. It's all like, look at this hand while I steal money from that. So this could affect the big legit charter boats, the 100, 120, 130 foot boats going in Miami, if they ban Miami Beach. I don't know what to tell you. Now, all the captains aren't bad. I mean, here's a captain that has maintained the center of the channel going down the Miami River, you can see. Now, I get it, the boat's underwater, but kudos to him. He stayed in the middle of the channel and out of everybody's way. It's a mess. More to come. All right, let's jump into... Tech Talk, technically speaking. Who do the crew agents work for? Because crew are under the impression that they work for them. Now, I hate to tell you, but it's not right. No. Okay, the crew agencies work for the people who are writing the checks, and that's the boats, okay? Crew are product that crew agencies are trying to sell to the customer, the yachts, okay? It's that simple. There's a lot of crew going, well, they didn't do anything for me. They didn't do this, they didn't do that. You know, I wouldn't recommend them. I wouldn't do this. I didn't do anything. You know, hey, how come I didn't, it's your fault I didn't get a job? As crew, you should be doing everything you can to get a job. You should be making sure your resume is top-notch, your references are top-notch. Don't embellish. I can't understand this for the life of me. Don't put references down if you got fired from the boat. I mean, what do you expect a captain to do? I hire him back. Yeah, no, I'm not. All right, it's your responsibility to get a job. You're utilizing the crew agency to help you get the job. Now, as a crew agency, it's kind of a funny thing. They need the boats and they need the crew. Crew's product, boats are customers. So not that they work for you, but they're there to help you succeed well because they want to place you. But if you're not placeable, all right, they're not going to bend over backwards. And guess what? You're not paying them anything. Why would you think that the crew agents work for you? Crew agency wages wages, I guess, vary from a couple of weeks to a month to 2 months of your wage that the boat pays, okay? And then they warranty you. They warranty you. So if you're a screw up, they're not gonna put you on a boat knowing that they're gonna have to replace you again. It's just as much work and they don't make any money. So never forget that you are in charge of your future, not somebody else, okay? This isn't like a corporate headhunter thing and you're the CEO of some major corporation where you sit there and negotiate, all right? Okay, we're gonna move into bottom feeders. Let's do bottom feeders. Give me the shark.
William and Kate.
Okay. A very special shout out and bottom feeders this week. As we all know, what's his name?
William and Kate.
Damn it.
You're doing this on purpose.
No, I'm not. That is my attention span. Very special shout out and bottom feeders. As we all know, William and Kate are in Boston, but I have the opportunity and privilege to have had dinner with Megan. Megan? Everybody, this is Megan. Megan, this is the Bottom Line Fan Club. I have one question for you. While you were in England, and I know you spent a lot of time there, but now that you're back in the United States, how is the butter? Okay, she's not good. Okay, so let me explain bottom feeders. Dana, and we were trying to do bottom feeders, but we all had too much to drink, so that didn't really work out. She was supposed to be Meghan Markle. It's kind of funny. I couldn't even remember. All right, but here, we're going to throw this picture up. Here are my bottom feeders this week. I got Dana Rodriguez, Dana Muntz, Victoria Barker, and Andrea Gonzalez, and Asora Horodova. I was actually at dinner with five beautiful women. It's just a fluke. I don't know what happened, but we had a blast. Thank you, girls, for watching. Victoria just came over from the UK. I mean, like a day before, she just joined a boat. Dana Rodriguez, she's actually on a boat with her boyfriend. And Dana Muntz, I'm sure most of you know, she's a freelance chef in the Fort Lauderdale area. And Andrea is going to school here at MPT, I think, and then she'll eventually be looking for a job. We had a ton of fun. So those are the girls of bottom feeders for this week. All right, let's jump into Crew Corner. Okay, Crew Corner brought to you by Crew Haven. Jamie over at crewhaven1501.com. Don't forget, if you need a place to stay in Fort Lauderdale, they're always expanding. They always have space. They're always next to the boat yards. We love Jamie over there. We're going to do an episode over there if I can ever, you know, we ever kind of match up, because our places are full all the time, so we can't go in there when they have crew. But if you need a place to stay, crewhaven1501.com. Don't call her if she's on her honeymoon. That's coming up soon. Okay, crew corner this week. If yachting isn't living up to your expectations, get the F out. I don't think I can say this any clearer. All right, and I'm not trying to be harsh, but people are getting hurt. People are dying, and I don't like this, okay? It's actually, I'll get into that in a minute. The biggest problem that we have in yachting right now is there is this big change in the perception of yachting, and we all know that that's probably a lot to do with a certain TV show on. So it's bringing a lot of young, new crew in to live that life, and it's not sitting well with new crew. They don't understand. What do you mean I can't get off the boat? What do you mean I have to work 6-7 days a week? What do you mean it's 18-hour days? What do you mean I can't go home? Younger crew are not adjusting well to this. There have been several suicides. There's been people who are being very vocal about being sad, and they can't deal with it anymore. And then, of course, there's the drinking. They fall into that. They fall into maybe drug use. And, you know, they jump boats thinking that that one was just a bad egg, and they get another one that's exactly the same or could be worse. All their friends are going, no, it's not that. It's not them. It's not you. It's them. But it really is. You're coming into the industry with expectations that are not going to be met. I've heard comments from other crew, owners are going to have to adjust. Now, I'm here to tell you, we are adjusting as much as we can to the new crew coming into the industry, but there's just certain things we can't change. We can't change the fact that you're going to be away from home. All right, just like the Navy, just like every commercial ship out there, boats, yachts move. And it's just impossible to think that you could be home every 3 or 4 days. You're going to leave home for months. Okay? Nobody's ever said yachting was easy. Yachting is difficult. There's a reason why the money is getting paid. All right. It's because there is a big sacrifice that everybody needs to make when you go to sea. It's not just yachts, it's ships, it's the military, it's everything. There have been more and more suicides on yachts. There have been more people who have mentally broken down. There's actually now support groups for yacht crew to deal with some of these issues. Unfortunately, I don't know if it ever will be what that show shows you. And for the record, that show, they're on the boat for 1 month and their charters are 3 days long. And then the producers take them out to these huge dinners. That's not real life yachting, and it's never going to be. There's no way that, you know, you can move a boat up to New England and have a charter, and then the captain goes, time out, we didn't get our 3 days off, we're going to push the charter back a week. It doesn't work. So, with not trying to be harsh about it, but if you have your opinion of yachting and it's not living up to your opinion, get the F off the boat. It's not worth killing yourself over, and it's not worth going crazy mentally, all right? There are plenty of other jobs out there. Just because you think that it's cool doesn't mean that you're cut out for yachting. So I'm not trying to be harsh. I'm trying to keep people from having mental breakdowns, because it's more and more. Anyway, we'll have a normal show next week. I'm Doug. Paige is somewhere. I don't know where she is. I think she's having fun somewhere. We'll have a normal show next week. And in the meantime, peace out.